United we're as strong as a mountain. United we're as deep as the sea. Stand together, shoulder to shoulder, sisters and brothers, united and free.
Country to the fore, eager smiles on eager faces, a nation's heart beating hard once more. Those in power knew just what they wanted. Divide and rule was their cry. When the foe
United in Fighting Amazon, our first speaker will be Kelly Kick from UFCW.
My name is Kelly Kick, and I'm a proud 28-year member of the United Food and Commercial Workers. I'm also a fiercely active delegate to the Contra Costa Labor Council. I'm honored and humbled to be here today with such an amazing show of force for the labor movement. International Workers' Day is a time to celebrate workers who've shared their blood, sweat, and tears for their jobs, for their employers, and put food on the tables of their families and took care of each other at work. And the working class has benefited from it. Thank you, workers of this country, for your service. Yeah! I appreciate you all. Yeah! I am impressed with what my union, UFCW 5, has done for me and all our members. Local 5 has made a historic settlement for our last grocery contract, the largest wage increase ever negotiated. Expanded health care benefits and secured pensions for our retirees. It is because we stood together as union members that we sent a message to our employers that we were willing to fight for our fair contract. UFCW 5 is on the forefront of legislating and unionizing the cannabis industry. I would like to acknowledge our newest family members, Hometown Heart San Francisco, currently fighting to get their first union contract. There's power in solidarity. All these people have your back going forward. Don't ever stop fighting. And that's what this is about. Power to the people, standing together for workers' rights. Look at the current wave of organization coming across this country. REI, Starbucks, Amazon, standing up to corporate greed and defending the need for living wages, health care, and equitable treatment. The time is now to organize. We implore Amazon, when you move into our neighborhoods, do not simply extract the resources. Be a good neighbor. Work with the San Francisco Southeast Alliance and give back to the communities in which you build. Provide green space. Create safely trafficked streets for our pedestrians and bicyclists. Provide affordable housing and local jobs. And when you do build your facilities, use union building trades to build your facilities. And staff your builds with skilled laborers that have the right and the ability to organize and form unions and fight for what they're worth. Imparting siblings, I want to call on all of you. You believe in this fight, I believe in this fight. This country continues to grow because of our efforts. As working class people, we can do more and we can be more. The time is now, right now. Organize, unionize, let's go. One union.
Thank you, Kelly. Our next speaker is organizing his own shop with his coworkers. workers. Let's give a warm welcome to Joe Thompson from Starbucks.
Thank you all so much for having me, and happy May Day! We will continue fighting for all of us, but just a little introduction. So yeah, I'm 19 years old. I'm a UC Santa Cruz student. So students are organizing their workplaces across the country. We will continue fighting for all workers. We will continue organizing and fighting against these greedy corporations who are trying to maximize profits and are hurting their workers. Yeah. What's disgusting?
Union busting!
Right, what's disgusting?
Union busting!
With Starbucks, they've been union busting in our own Santa Cruz store since the very beginning. That's right. We filed for the first union election in California, January 1st, 2022, and now we will have the first unionized Starbucks on May 11th in Santa Cruz. This victory is not only for our movement, but for all workers. We will continue winning at Starbucks. We will continue winning at Amazon, at Chevron, and to all workforce in the United States that want to unionize are unionized. The real question is, how are we going to get there? How are young people going to stand up and fight back? And the way we're doing it is organizing from worker to worker. Workers are deciding enough is enough, and we need to continue building the relationships that are needed to organize. You know, as 19 years old, I didn't know how to organize. We were never taught this in school. One of the things that I will be fighting for and continue fighting for is educating our workforces on how to organize effectively, and how to win. It is a pleasure to be here with all of you guys. I love seeing the solidarity throughout this community. We are in this together. Solidarity forever! Thank you all so much. Have a happy May Day.
Okay, folks, there's a group of workers who've been on strike for over 60 days in the East Bay. The Chevron workers have been holding out, marching the line for well over 60 days. I want to introduce BKY.
Power to the people. It's great to be out here with you. I want you to know the steel workers sharing the solidarity with all the workers here, all the workers around the world, all the workers around the nation, those who are organized and those who have yet to be organized, because we will get them. Workers throughout the U.S., are starting to get fed up with being exploited, being left behind, not having health care, and we're standing up. Yeah. And as workers, we were amazed watching the Amazon workers, who, by the way, their labor is so valuable that they made one of the richest men in the world. Those workers should be the highest paid workers in the world. Yeah. We stand by and have solidarity with Starbucks workers, the teachers of Oakland who stood up and said no privatization of the schools or closing of the schools, the public schools. We stand in solidarity with them. We stand in solidarity with the SEIU, with the ILWU, with the people, the Teamsters who came out to our line. Solidarity is the only thing that keeps us going. I'm so proud of the women and men of my refinery who stood up against a behemoth and said enough is enough, that we deserve more. The working class people are an intelligent people. We see what's going on in the United States. We were promised a piece of the pie, but we're left to clean it up. We were told to pull ourselves up by our bootstraps, but we end up with the boots on our necks. They tell us of a land of milk and honey. We're fighting just to get beans and rice. Right. We've been on fight for 60 days, but I've been fighting my whole life. Right on. We will continue to fight until we get a fair and equitable contract.
So you're right.
We have environmentalists who stood up for us, and we will stand up for them when they call us.
Yeah.
And for all the workers who stood up for us, we will be there for you. Yeah. Power to the people.
You know, no other profession has been maligned more over the last 2 years than our teachers.
Yes!
They've been attacked by politicians. They've been attacked by people on the streets. But we love our teachers! Yeah. And one of the highlights of the big fight that's coming up here in San Francisco, we have Mary Brave Woman from AFT 2121.
Happy May Day, everybody. My name is Mary Brave Woman. I'm the Vice President of AFT 2121, representing teachers at City College of San Francisco. City College means the world to me and my family. I was once told I wasn't college material, that I'd be better off if I simply went off and got married. Instead, I proudly graduated with honors from CCSF. I came back for 12 years as a classified worker, proud member of SEIU 10 to 1, before becoming a mathematics teacher.
Yes. Yes.
And City College belongs to our students, every one of whom who has great promise and hope are my inspiration. And City College is the largest and most accessible resource for degrees, job training in our city. It's a beacon for Black, Brown, working class, immigrant, and disabled San Franciscans. And our students are your past, present, and future members.
Yes! Woo!
And we, the working class of San Francisco, are the heartbeat of this city. But this moment, each of us and our communities are grappling with widening inequities and gentrification. And our institutions, those that lift up the underrepresented, are under attack. How many of you have taken a class at City College? Woo! Did it change your life and influence you in the way that it did mine? Yes. City College has served generations of San Franciscans, including my daughter and her single mother. That's right. Didn't take that advice. And that is why I am fighting for the future of our beloved institution. Last year, our union members took deep salary concessions to preserve the heartbeat of our city, to protect our students and the programs they depend on. We brought financial stability to the college through collective sacrifice. We protected hundreds of classes for thousands of students and saved 600 jobs. Now our district has millions in reserves and plans to increase those millions by laying off over 200 faculty and over 50 classified workers. That's right. These cuts will cut vital services to students and student supports and over 20,000 educational opportunities for the future workforce of San Francisco. Tens of thousands of our students will lose, and these cuts will only perpetuate cycles of more cuts, enrollment decline, and financial woes. It is time to end this austerity mindset. It is time to stop the downward spiral of this death cut. It is time to invest in our educational institutions. I am asking you to stand with our workers, demand that CCSF Board of Trustees, Bridget Davila, John Rizzo, Chanel Williams, Thea Selby, Alia Chisti, and Alan Wong preserve the educational opportunities of our students and vote no on these layoffs.
Yeah!
I am asking you to stand for the heartbeat of City College. Join us Tuesday, May 3rd at noon for a press conference in front of Collin Hall on the Ocean Campus, and make sure that everyone knows how City College belongs not to the Chancellor and not to the trustees, but to the community she serves,
yeah,
including all of us. If you see us in our AFT 2121 t-shirts, ask us how you can get involved. We have flyers and sign-up sheets. We are proud to be an integral part of the labor movement in San Francisco. And we stand today in solidarity with all the workers in all their struggles on International Workers' Day. Thank you.
strong in protest. Our public sector workers fought like hell, and they got a great contract. Let's hear it for the public sector workers who stood up. My next speaker I want to introduce, he's no stranger to May Day, Trent Willis, ILWU Local 10.
All right, thank you, brothers and sisters. And I just want to say from the ILWU Local 10, happy May Day to each and every union out here. Give yourselves a round of applause. Now, as I get started here, I just want to recognize and send a shout out to certain unions that I don't represent, however, I might be up here speaking for. And I want to send a shout out to the ILWU Local 34, is in the house. The ILWU Local 6. ILWU Local 75. ILWU Local 91. And the Inland Boatmen's Union is here with us today. I also want to send a shout out to another organization that I represent, an organization called SLAP. All right. Yeah. Now, if you didn't hear on Friday, we had a demonstration in Oakland where the ILWU Local 10 and the OEA, Oakland Teachers Association, teamed up to create an organization called SLAP. And the reason we created that organization is because we are working people that are tired of getting represented, are tired of not being represented, excuse me. We are workers that understand the meaning of gentrification and how gentrification contributes to the wealth gap. Now, for those of you who don't know, the wealth gap is wider than it's ever been in the history of this country. Right now, the wealth gap is larger than it's ever been in the history of this country. Now, every time in history that the wealth gap got too wide, there was a response from working people in unions. Right. And we need that response now. We need that response yesterday. We need that response immediately. You know, there's a lot of politics involved in the labor movement. Each and every one of us know that. It's time to put all politics aside. It's time to unite as working people. Some of our later labor leaders haven't heard us. They will hear us. We are deadly serious about closing this wealth gap. Is everybody with me? I said, is everybody with me? Now, before I go on, you can join that organization because we're organizing in our own name. We're organizing so that we can control who gets voted in office and who doesn't. We are also organizing so we can control who gets voted in the union office and who doesn't. Who gets to hold positions on the labor council and who doesn't. See, we need to do all of that because the people who hold these positions, they need to be accountable to working people. Anybody who is rubbing shoulders with politicians and billionaires, you're playing on the wrong team. So before you leave here today, get on Google and look up SLAP. It's called it's Schools and Labor Against Privatization. Now this march today, it's Schools and Labor Against Privatization, slapbayarea.org. Make sure you look that up. Now, what we're doing here today is we're commemorating a very famous strike. We're commemorating the general strike in 1934. Right. And we all know who sparked that strike. It was the ILWU Local 10.
Yeah.
Labor from all across the city and counties and all over the Bay Area joined us in striking that day.
That's right.
And it made a huge difference for the labor movement. Now what we're doing out here today is we're reenacting that. We're acting. Does everybody hear what I'm saying? We're acting today. We need to do this for real. This is just a shot over the bow for the billionaires and the corporations. This is a shot over the bow. We're letting you hear our voices today. Okay, but soon enough, you're gonna hear it in your pocketbooks. We need to have another general strike. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm an ILWU member. I'm from Local 10. We ain't scared of Local 10. Okay? On Friday, April 29th, we did it for real. Those cranes were stuck up in the air for real. The OEA did it for real. The OEA had a one-day strike for real. There was no talking. There was no posturing. We did it for real. We walked out. Because the only way that you're going to make a difference in this society is you have to use your labor. If you're not using your labor to make a difference, you're not doing nothing. We need to tell our labor leaders that. We need to tell our elected officials that. We won't go to work until you start acting right. That's what we need to do. So once again, I was here last year, and I stood up here, and I made a commitment, and I told the future. And I said that Local 10 was going to honor one of the most courageous sisters that I've ever known, and that we were going to make her an honorary member of the ILWU Local 10. And I'm standing here proudly today to tell you that we have done that. We have made this sister an honorary member of our local, because what she stands for is what we stand for. And that's complete 100% social justice. That sister is sitting behind me today. But before I introduce her, since we're commemorating the 1934 general strike today, I want my Local 10 brothers and sisters to do me a favor. I want everybody to know who you are today. I always tell you guys, always know who you are. And who you are leaders in the labor movement. The labor movement needs you. So when I say union, you say fight. Union.
Fight.
Union.
Fight.
When I say people, you say fight. People.
Fight.
People.
Fight.
When I say local, you say 10. Local.
10.
Local.
10.
Local.
10. 10. 10.
Right on. Right on. Now, without further ado, I want to introduce this beautiful sister who has stood for social justice her entire life and has made the ultimate sacrifices for working people, poor people, and the disenfranchised. I want to introduce her. I can't say enough about her, but I'm going to shut my mouth now and let her say something about herself. Sister Angela Davis, honorary member of ILWU Local 10.
Thank you so much, Trent. Now, there is no other place that I would rather be on this day, May Day, May 1st, 2022, than gathered here with you, marching with all of you down Market Street. Happy May Day, everyone. I spoke last year, and I wasn't with my union, or my union hadn't yet claimed me. But now I am here as an honorary member of the ILWU Local 10. And I think they had the idea to offer me an honorary membership when I said at the port in 2020 that if I had not become a university professor, I would have become a longshore worker. So let me say that I am so proud to be here, especially in the aftermath of the action on Friday that Trent described, the action against privatization of Oakland schools and against the privatization of the port. And I, you know, one of the things that has drawn me to this union over and over again, aside from the fact that they supported me when I was in jail, aside from the fact that they sparked the anti-apartheid movement in the Bay Area, aside from the fact that they led, they continue to lead the movement to free Mumia Abu-Jamal. And so, you know, I want to say that I so appreciate ILWU Local 10 because of the persistence in supporting Mumia, not only here in the Bay Area, not only in this country, but internationally. And we had an amazing gathering of international unions last February in which people called for the freedom of Mumia. And so I think that increasingly all over the world, people know that freedom for Mumia and also freedom for Leonard Peltier and all political prisoners will be a blow against global capitalism. It will be a blow against racism. It will be a blow against racial capitalism. So free Mumia, free Leonard, free all political prisoners. Now, you see, I have two buttons on today. One says workers' action to free Mumia Abu-Jamal. The other one says reject the recall Chesa Boudin. And I want to tell you that Chesa was planning to speak today on his own behalf. But he had to rush last night to New York to spend his mother's last hours with her. And as we were marching down Market Street, Kathy passed on. And Chesa sent me the text saying that she was gone. And Kathy is one of my oldest friends. We've known each other since high school. And we've done work against the prison industrial complex for the last 20-some years since Kathy herself was released from prison. And so I think it is, in a way, symbolic that she decided to depart on this day, on this day. And I told Chesa that I would do my best to urge all of you to work against the recall. No on Proposition H. And now, what I want to say is that none of us can dispute the fact that so many billionaires, and I, you know, I guess I have to call Trent up to talk about the billionaires again. But the wealth of all of the billionaires has increased during the pandemic. As a matter of fact, many of them have seen their fortunes double. Now, why do I say this? I say this because working people have borne the brunt of this pandemic. If you know, want to understand the nature of this crisis, look at all of the people who have lost their jobs. Look at people who have been evicted. And why do I make this point? Because if we want to understand why the crime rates have risen, it's not about the policies of Chesa Boudin. It's not about the fact that he decided to prosecute wage theft. It's not about the fact that he decided to make police more accountable. It's not about the fact that he abolished cash bail as soon as he took office. It's about the damage that the capitalists have done to working people who have no other choice than sometimes to take desperate measures. So do not allow them to confuse you. We have to protect Chesa. You have to excuse me, I have a cold, so as a matter of fact, I've been telling people I'm giving you the elbow, you know, not the hand, because I don't want to pass my cold on to you. But this is a critical juncture, and I want to urge all of you to do whatever you can during the next period to make sure everybody in the city who believes in working people, everybody who is opposed to racism, votes no on H. No on H. No on H. No on H. No on H.
No on H. No on H.
And also, it's not only about ending the craziness that has been produced by this recall campaign. It's about creating real measures for safety and security and health, using abolitionist strategies to create a world that is going to be safe for our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren and so forth and so on. So as we go out to guarantee that Chesa is not recalled, and I understand that the Chronicle just endorsed him, am I right?
Yes.
So, you know, that's a great starting point. But I want to end also by recalling the chants that have echoed around the world, thanks to my union, thanks to ILWU Local 10. An injury to one is an injury to all. Free Mumia Abu Jamal. An injury to one is an injury to all. Free Mumia Abu Jamal. Thank you.